Hi, I'm Tony with Cirris. Today we're going to go over the Easy-Touch Pro and we're going to do some basic setup and testing. Show you how easy it is to use. This is the Easy-Touch Pro. It runs our Easyware software. It has a 128 test points, can be expanded out to 1024. Has built-in digital I/O, has Ethernet, so you can connect it to your network, has four USB slots, and it has the capability of connecting to Cirris Server. Cirris Server, you can have multiple EasyTouch testers using all of the same tests, so you're not having to load each test on each machine. They use the same database. It has the capability of testing at 2000 volts DC. Okay, to plug it in, you plug the power cord into the back of the tester, and then you push and hold this power button for at least 1 second to get the tester to power on. So this is the user screen. You have the capability to set up line workers, master login, test engineers. Right now it's set to master login with no password because I haven't set up security yet. Just hit the OK button and it will boot you into the Easyware software. This is our Easyware software. It gives you the capability to create tests within minutes using the learn function. You can create your tests on your own, but why? Use the Easyware software. It does all the hard work for you. It also has the capability of creating reports. You can either print them, export them as PDF or CSV file formats. The Easy-Touch Pro has a touchscreen, so you don't need to use a keyboard or mouse. The way you connect your cable to the Easy-Touch Pro is using the Cirris adapter system. You have a single high, which takes up 32 test points. You have the double high, which takes up 64 test points. And you have a quad board, which will take up 128 test points. The Cirris adapter system comes in a wide variety of connectors. While you're setting up your test and you have a question on something on the screen that you need help with, you can touch that help button, and at any time on any one of our screens in the lower right-hand corner, there will be a help button that will tell you exactly what is on that screen with flyovers. All you have to do is touch it and it will tell you about what it is. Now we're going to set up a test using a batch of these simple cables. To install a Cirris adapter, we're going to first line it up, slide in until you feel a little bit of tension. Then you're going to seat the connector by adding pressure to the back of the connector. If it's seated, the slide lock will easily slide in behind the adapter. To learn a cable, you're going to hit Create Test. You're going to pick Learn Test Program. You can change your defaults here. This is the connection resistance. This is the maximum value of resistance you're going to allow for a wire connection. Default is 10 ohms. The low voltage insulation resistance is used to determine if you have a short or a high resistance connection. You want to set this high, so you pick up a high resistance connection under 100 kOhms. We want to run a high voltage test, so we're going to leave high voltage testing on checked. Since we're using high voltage, we'll go into the set high voltage parameters to show you what it looks like. This is where you'll set up all of your high voltage. But at this time, we'll cover this in another video. During the learn, we have the option to check for capacitors, diodes, resistors, twisted pair, or we can learn four wire. But at this time, we're not going to use them because the cable we have doesn't have any. Okay, stored error details is typically checked by default. Stored measured values, I feel, is important because it shows the resistance values that the test actually captured on your wire connections. So after you hit the learn function, it's going to automatically take you into the test editor. As you can see, it learned all of the wire connections. Now, if you want to change any of your test parameters, we can go into Test Defaults tab. There's a couple options with the Signature Continuous and Signature Single Test modes. You'll see that the assembly attached is the default. That means when you connect the cable, it will start testing. If you decide to choose the Signature Single Test, which will do just one pass at the cable and not check for intermittence continuously, you'll see that the default test mode is start button is pressed. The cable is attached. It will check for the attach and tell you to attach a cable to test, but it's going to ask you to hit the start button instead of automatically starting the test. For this demo, we're going to choose the signature continuous test. So this is the best way to check for intermittence or problems like opens, bad solder joints, bad crimps. Sometimes we can catch those type of errors with this test mode. We're going to finish editing. We're going to save our test. This will take you out back to the main screen where the test will be highlighted and you'll be able to now test that product. If you want to make a change to a test that you've already created, you'll highlight the test. You'll hit the edit button. It will load into the editor, and then you can make any change that you need to. You can change the test method, add a report, add barcodes or serial numbers. Now that we have the test made, we're going to highlight the test if it's not already highlighted. We're going to hit the test button. The tester will load the test program and tell you to attach the cable to start. With the continuous test mode, you're going to see that the tester automatically starts the test. It's already through the low voltage test that fast. Now it wants us to high pot. It passed the high pot and testing good. So now we'll disconnect the cable. It will tell you that it's good. As soon as we connect a new cable on, it'll start a new test. That fast, the low voltage test is done. We'll do high pot. It's good. As you can see, the test count down here, 2 good, 0 bad. So now that I've showed you how that we test the cable and you get good results, we're gonna try to do an intermittent connection to show you what a continuous test looks like when it's not working right. So there's an open. You'll see that it's seeing that it's still testing, but it's not allowed you to go to high pot yet. If you were to disconnect this cable right now, you would have a bad cable showing that you had intermittence and the tester never went to high pot. That is why it's saying test not complete is because we didn't do the high pot test, but it is a bad cable. This has been a demo of the Easy-Touch Pro. If you have any questions, contact us with the information on the screen. It does all the work. You do? So you can save them out on your network somewhere. Battery died. For this, we're going to use this batch of simple cables.
One more time.
As you see, it says good.
Sorry, we can do it.